Dear students, now I am going to take sum number 20 and sum number 21 of your first model paper in 12th. Problem number 20 is a problem under probability and 21 is a problem under what's a rank. Right. And in 16 throws of a die, getting an even number is considered as a success. In 16 throws of a die, getting an even number is considered as a success, then the variance of the successes is. So here, there are 16 throws, so n is 16. P is probability of getting an even number. When a die is thrown, what are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6. When a die is rolled, the even numbers are, what's a 2, 4, 6. So the favorable is 3. Total is 6. When a die is rolled, the even numbers are 2, 4, 6. So favorable is 3, total 6. So P is equal to what, sir? 1 by 2. So N is 16, P is what, sir? 1 by 2. Therefore, Q. Q is equal to what? 1 minus P. Q is equal to what? 1 minus P. Therefore, it is 1 minus 1 by 2. P is 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2. Is 1 by 2. You are asked to find out the variance. Variance is equal to what, sir? This is a problem under what? Binomial distribution. This is a problem under binomial distribution. Variance is equal to NPQ. You know that. Variance is equal to NPQ. N is 16. P is 1 by 2. And Q is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into 16 into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 is what's up 4. So what is the variance? Variance is 4. Variance is 4. Variance is 4. So let us also find the other items in this. So as far as this problem is concerned, what is your choice? The choice is the first choice and the answer is 4. So this is my choice. The choice is first choice and the answer is 4. Answer, first choice, it is 4. So what is the mean of the binomial distribution? The mean of the binomial distribution is n into p. The mean of the binomial distribution is n into p, that is 16 into 1 by 2. 16 into 1 by 2 is 8. It is not asked. Supposing if it is asked, you must be in a position to do it. For that purpose only I am doing this. Then similarly, variance is NPQ. Mean is N into P. Variance is NPQ, which is nothing but what, sir? 14. And standard deviation. Standard deviation is root NPQ. Standard deviation is what, sir? Root NPQ. Which is nothing but what? Root 4 is 2. Clear, sir? So, for a binomial distribution, mean is N into P, variance is NPQ, standard deviation is what, sir? Root NPQ. Where N is the number of trials, P is what? Probability of success, or P is probability of getting the event in a single trial, and Q is equal to what, sir? 1 minus P. And in binomial distribution, mean is always greater than variance. In binomial distribution, mean is always greater than variance. Mean is greater than variance in a binomial distribution. The probability binomial distribution is a discrete random variable. And the probability mass function of the binomial distribution. The probability mass function of the binomial distribution is P of x is equal to NCX P power x Q power n minus x. Dear students, that is the reason why I say when I do a problem, I don't confine myself in doing that problem alone. Right? Now I am going to what, sir? 21st problem. The rank of a diagonal matrix. Listen here, finding the rank of a diagonal matrix is very, very simple. You know what is a diagonal matrix? Diagonal matrix is a matrix in which the leading diagonal entries need not be zero. The rest of the entries will be zero. That is, all the entries above the leading diagonal, similarly, all the entries below the leading diagonal will be zero. Or all the entries above the main diagonal or all the entries below the main diagonal will be zero. So, diagonal matrix is a square matrix in which the entries along the main diagonal or leading diagonal need not be zero, and the entries above the main diagonal and the entries below the main diagonal will be zero. And you are asked to find out the rank. Listen here, for finding the rank of a diagonal matrix, it is simple. So, you consider the diagonal entries. If there are, this is my diagonal entry. That is, this is my leading diagonal entry or main diagonal entry. This is my leading diagonal entry or main diagonal entry. If there are three non-zero elements, in the diagonal matrix, then the rank is 3. If there are two non-zero diagonal entries, then the rank is 2. If there are 4 non-zero elements or 4 non-zero entries along the main diagonal, then the rank is 4. Here, the number of non-zero entries along the main diagonal is 3. The number of non-zero elements along the leading diagonal is 3. This is non-zero, this is non-zero, this is non-zero. So, there are 3 non-zero entries along the main diagonal, therefore rank is 3. If there are 2 non-zero entries along the main diagonal, then the rank is 2. If there are 4 non-zero entries along the main diagonal, then the rank is 4. Of course, this is applicable only for diagonal matrix. Clear, sir? So, if it is a diagonal matrix and there are 3 non-zero entries along the main diagonal, therefore rank is 3. For this, assume that I am having one more diagonal entry. This is a diagonal matrix. And this is my diagonal entry, leading diagonal entry. This is my leading diagonal entry. How many non-zero entries are there in the diagonal matrix? There are 2 non-zero entries. There are 2 non-zero entries, therefore rank is equal to 2. Clear, my dear students? You understand this well?